Daniel House breaking down the NFL draft. You can catch him on Score North and also on Gopher Hole. We would also like to break down the 2021 commits and some recent activity from PJ Fleck and historic type activity, especially considering a top 50 player, regardless of position, committing to Minnesota football.
Yeah, Avante Dickerson from Nebraska, cornerback, top player in the state of Nebraska, going down and stealing a player from Scott Frost's neighborhood. Gopher fans really took joy in going to read the message boards that Nebraska fans were posting about the commitment. Six-rated DB in the country right now. Second highest rated player in program history during the internet era, according to 24/7 Sports. One of the things I love about him is recovery speed. He's able to get into passing lanes and use his speed to get back in the passing lane and break up a pass. Ball skills are really good. The transition quickness that you're looking for, back pedal to open in your hips. Those are some of the things that teams are looking for when they're adding defensive back commits. So definitely when you're beating out teams like LSU, Georgia, Ohio State, teams like that, you're winning big recruiting battles. And without having guys physically on campus, virtual visits are becoming the new thing, and PJ Fleck has been dominant with the virtual visits, landing a lot of big commits during the month of April.
Why does that not surprise me that PJ Fleck would prosper in that type of environment? Certainly his face-to-face with the former handshake being part of the process, he certainly excels there as well, but I can certainly see him transitioning to social media and to the virtual very well.
They were ahead of the game with their virtual recruiting, and PJ Fleck was talking about that recently, being able to have something set so guys could take a look at campus without even setting foot there. It's been a big advantage, especially when maybe other schools aren't as far ahead there. So landing a player like Dickerson just as a cornerstone of the class, and Stephen Ortiz Jr. from Goodyear, Arizona, versatile player, reminds me a lot of the things that Antoine Winfield can do. He projects as a nickel cornerback at Minnesota, but the physicality, versatility, it's the ball skills too, being able to make plays all the time. He's got that defensive back swagger when you pull up his tape. The Gophers are building their secondary for the future, and with 2-4 stars at the cornerback position looking ahead right now, the strength of this team on the defensive side of the ball is going to be corner next year with Coney Durr, Benjamin St. Juice. There's some uncertainty at the nickel cornerback position, but looking ahead, these players are going to play a huge role in the development of this secondary, and Joe Rossi and PJ Fleck have done a nice job, and his entire staff, of finding defensive back talent and injecting that into the roster.
And just to be clear, if you're looking at the recruiting rankings, I believe Dickerson, a top 50 overall player, according to ESPN, the 247 Sports composite has him at 93. And if you know anything about recruiting, once you get up into that top 300, it's rarefied air, and especially in the top 100, of course. And yep. For Ortiz, he's a top 23 rated cornerback out of Arizona. Excellent stuff, Daniel. We always appreciate you stopping by, breaking down Minnesota football. And you stay safe. Hope everything's going well. Hopefully we've got some football projected on the field in regards to training camp coming up at some point soon.
I hope so. Stay safe, Mark. Thanks for having me.